Well, this morning we've been helping you better understand how to give CPR if someone needs it. But the American Heart Association's Awareness Week also includes AED training.
Jenna James joins us now with information so we can better understand that box that we see on walls of so many places, including our offices. Jenna, good morning.
Hey, good morning, Dave and Cerise. Yeah, the AED, or the automatic external defibrillator, that's this weird thing that you normally see on the wall. Now, this can actually help in a lot of situations. So here's how it works. You hit the on button, give it a second.
Call for help.
And it'll start
Remove
talking to you.
From
I'm going to turn it off so you can actually hear what I'm saying. But it'll actually start talking to you and walking you through exactly what you need to do. For instance, like exposing the person's chest and applying these pads to the areas that it shows right here on the packet. And then after that, you want to let go of the person, wait till it's done analyzing, and then hit the shock button if they need it. And it's going to let you know exactly when you need to hit that button. And while this seems like it's really complicated, it might be a lot, you just have to remind yourself that you can do this.
Training helps a lot by staying calm, knowing that you are the person there that needs to help. You can do this. I can think about it. I can think positive. I can do this. And then it just kind of goes into autopilot for most of the people.
Now, all of this is designed for when someone goes into cardiac arrest, and you can check this by checking an unconscious person and trying to find a pulse. Now, after you do that, shock is when you want to resume CPR. But to truly understand this or CPR, the American Heart Association says that we need to take classes to become certified. I'll post information on WWT.com on how you can do that. Coming up in the next half hour, 60 seconds to save a life. I'll show you just what that means. Reporting live, Jenna James, WWT 6 News.